Well, good afternoon or good morning to everyone. Last week was a very challenging game against Jackson State. We knew that their defense was going to be good. Their offense had showed glimpses of being able to move the ball. But the thing about it, our defense has been playing well and getting better all week. We were able to control the clock, buy time for our defense to get some turnovers, get some short fields where we were able to get some scores out of it. So it was hard-fought contest, change in the weather. It was about 87 degrees, so we had to take that into consideration to make sure, you know, we didn't have guys dehydrating. But, you know, again, our conditioning through Mega Harrison, our trainer, and our strength and conditioning, and LT, our trainer, is phenomenal. And we was able to get it done.
Coach, you got Grambling State coming in this week, undefeated in SWAC, reigning SWAC champions. What do you expect from the team this week?
Well, you know, like I told the guys, you know, they're Grambling, rich tradition. They're number 11 in the country. They're number one in this poll, number one in that poll. But they put 11 guys out there to field at a time. We'll put our 11 out, and we want to match their intensity. And we're going to play a football game. So we're going to play the men that's in the helmet and not the letter on the side.
You got them at home, which a lot of people say that's been a curse for Alabama State. You play better on the road. How did you get your team to focus and play at home?
Well, you know, week to week is the coach's responsibility to get those guys to be up to play regardless where you play at. And we're not going to even start listening to home being a curse. You know, home is home. And we're going to play hard. We're going to get them prepared to play against Grambling. And we've had a difficult home schedule, you know, thus far. But the bottom line, we'll be prepared and we'll be ready to play Grambling.
How important will it be to control the clock in this game? Obviously, Grambling's a very explosive team.
Well, you know, the thing about it, we have to contain them. We have to slow them down. And again, controlling the clock is part of our formula and philosophy of winning. We have to be able to run the football. We have to be able to wear the defense down. We don't have and we haven't found those explosive players on offense to be able to run hurry up and score in a minute and 15 seconds. So we have to complement the whole entire team by controlling the ball, getting more downhill, getting a lot more physical as we've done in the last three weeks. So it's very important to control, have some ball control going against Grambling.
Might be a silly question, but how do you get more of those explosive plays so that maybe you can?
Well, you know, if you look at our roster, the majority of our young men, other than two offensive linemen, maybe three, returns and a tight end. So you're talking about losing four young men. You're talking about three redshirt freshmen at quarterback, redshirt freshmen at wide receiver, true freshmen at wide receiver, true freshmen at running back. You know, as they get stronger in the program, as they get more familiar with what we want them to do, that's when the explosion comes. Right now, these guys are trying to find their way. We have about four guys that's playing on offense that if the program had a little bit more depth, they wouldn't probably play until their sophomore year. So, but they've been forced to play early. And with that, it's growing pain. So we have to take that in consideration with the things that we're asking them to do. And that's why you haven't seen a bunch of balls thrown down the field, a bunch of guys running tunnel screens and all those things, because it's two things that can happen to a freshman if you play him early. He's either going to have success and turn out real good, or he's going to have failure and turn out real bad. And we're just trying to guard against the failure and losing 3 years and letting these guys have some success so we can gain them over the next 4 years.
Coach, the defense has strung together some solid games, obviously, especially last week, four interceptions. Talk about the confidence level of that defense and how they're playing right now, especially coming off the JSU game.
They're swarming. They're playing real physical. They look forward to forcing turnovers. And, you know, Ronnie 2 weeks ago had a score. And this week, Jeff Hill, Ronnie couldn't play because of the ankle. And Jeff Hill was able to get in and get two interceptions. So You know, they're showing up to work every single day in every single game. So anytime that you, it's normally about 12 opportunities that each side of it, that each opponent, that each person has, whether it's offensive, whether it's Grambling or ourselves, it normally equates to 12 opportunities. And when you can negate and take four of those away, now they only have eight possessions and we have 16, that creates more opportunity for us. So as we talk to them about those 12, that we want to try to take about three or four possessions from every team to give us more opportunity. They've been able to do that week in and week out.
What continues to be your message to the team with so much ride? I mean, there was the start of the season, and then you guys are on a three-game winning streak. What continues to be your message to keep things as positive and flowing as positive as they have been the last few weeks?
It's just the opportunity to be able to play. You know, so many young men, and God bless the young man that's at Park Crossing. You go out, you go to practice, or you go to a game, and the game is taken away from you. And I think sometimes we get so caught up into the win that we forget the development and the process that the intentions of sports was put in our head. It wasn't just to win, it was to create morale and to, you know, create drive in men later. And the thing that I constantly, you know, put before them is that enjoy the moment. Once you've done the best that you can do, if you're able to win with that, take that success and move forward. But if you fall, learn from that and move forward. That 0-5, it will serve a purpose in these guys' lives when they lose their job and now they have to go and get a family together. You know, they have had success after being down. So I just continue to always speak positive. If a guy drops a ball, you know, I don't yell, catch the ball, because I really think he wants to catch the ball. I try to find, hey, you ran a great route. And I know he understands that his job is to catch the ball, and nobody wants to be a failure. So you don't have to remind them that they failed. You have to remind them that the opportunity will come again for you to present yourself as a winner and make that play. And we constantly speak positive to them, and it's about the delivery. When I correct them, I put a hand on them just to talk to them. You know, when they know you care, they tend to do a little bit better for you. And it's not one of them that's in their helmet that can't tell you that I don't just take the time just to care about them, just to, hey, how's your mom? How's your dad? Hey, look, your people are going to be watching you this weekend. The game is televised. Hey, man, make your granddaddy proud. Those are the things people have to have reasons to play for something. And each one of these young men have either a grandmother, a mother, father, or friends somewhere at home they want to play for. You got to constantly put that before them that you're not playing for me. It's not about the guy in the hat. It's about the guy in the helmet.
Knowing that you still control your own destiny, can be able to play for a swag title along with the Celebration Bowl, like, what extra motivation do you send to your players going in?
Win every play. It's you know, at the end, we'll tally up the wins to see, you know, whether we go into the Celebration Bowl or the Turkey Bowl. I mean, everybody don't get a chance to go to postseason play. And sure, we understand that the opportunity presents itself, but if you get to putting the cock before the horse, and now they get to the Celebration Bowl before they get to Grambling and before they get to Mississippi Valley, then nothing ever comes to fruition. Our thing is that we want to win every play of every game. And that's the thing that we focus on. It's not about where, you know, what lies ahead. It's about this game. This particular game is the only thing that matters.
I'll ask because kickers don't get a lot of love, and because he's a local guy. Hunter Hansen and his development, and is he growing in confidence and becoming more of what you could see as a weapon for this team?
Anytime that you can get the ball on the 30-yard line and the team, you know, now they yell, Coach Hunter! So it's definitely a weapon. I mean, and that has been a vast improvement from last year where, I mean, we struggled even inside the 20, and to have a freshman, again, a young man that struggled that first game, and we stuck with him, and he stuck with us, and now, I mean, you know, he practices hard, you know, and is great, just a pleasant person. I get the opportunity of being the kickers coach, so to see him every morning when he shows up, he has a great sense of humor, and himself as well as Trevor have a great sense of humor, and those guys, they stick together, they work on, you know, they work on the trades, and now to see this young man as a freshman, with the future definitely looks bright in our kicking game with him around.
Anything else?
Thank you.